Guys, so I'm making, So I'm making Carribean coconut shrimp, put a little parsley. I use coconut oil, condensed milk, water, salt, sugar, and coconut oil. And I'm gonna stir it up. I have it on a high light right now. I have cream of coconut also. Put it on a highlight. Let it cook for 20 minutes. Have it on the highest light. I wish you guys could smell it. It smells so good. I'm having seafood all month. I also plan on cooking fried lobster till this week. But since I'm not a fan of April and I'm not a big fan of Aries, it's only a few Aries that I get along with that I like actually. They're so bossy, so dominant, so strong. And I'm making Carribean coconut shrimp, condensed milk, coconut oil, parsley flakes, cream of coconut, sugar, water, a little bit of earth, wind, and fire. So I let it cook on a high light for 20 minutes. I'm gonna put a little bit more sugar in it. Put a little bit more sugar. There we go. Remember, when you're cooking sugar, sugar heats really fast. It burns really fast. So yeah. And that's the base. Now, I'm going to let it simmer. We'll put it on a low light. Put the light really low. You see? You see how everything calmed down? You see? Look, you see how all the smoke calmed down and all the bubbling calmed down? So cool. But yeah, I decided to make Carribean coconut shrimp. Oh, it smells so good. If you can smell it, it smells so good. I'm a big fan of coconut. I love coconut so much. Coconut milk, cream of coconut, coconut flakes. I'm a big fan of coconut. So yeah, it's on a low simmer. I think I'm gonna put a little bit lower. Put it a little bit lower. Be sure not to use no oil in this. I wouldn't recommend using no vegetable oil. Replace it with coconut oil. Pinch of salt. Half a cup of water. Oh. I'm gonna let it simmer for a good 10 minutes. Some more cream of coconut. I used the whole bag. So if you're buying the stick cream of coconut, be sure to use the whole thing. Depending on how much you want. I'm making more shrimp, so I decided to use the whole thing for the coconut sauce. Everyone on YouTube make their sauces different. This is my first time making it. I had another plate earlier and it came out really good, so it's really good. I'd use no butter. I use no vegetable oil. I just stuck to the authentic roots. if anyone's for the Caribbean watching this, if I made it different or made it the wrong way, leave a comment. I don't mind. You can leave a comment. I do not mind. Everyone makes it different. And there it is. I want it a little bit creamy, a little thicker, but I'm gonna taste it right quick and let you know if it's creamy, if it's watery, if it's fine. I'm gonna let you guys know how it tastes. Ooh, hot. It's just perfect. It is just perfect. I want a little bit of more, a little bit of more salt to balance out the sugar. So I'm going to use a little bit of salt, sprinkle a little bit of salt. That's enough. A little bit of salt to break down the sugar and balance it out. And I'm going to give it one more taste. Oh boy, so good. So good. Here's my Caribbean shrimp. I'm going to make this on a bed of rice. White rice. I don't have no snow peas right now, but I got broccoli and white rice. I have broccoli and white rice. It's really good. The sauce is really good. If you're watching this, you can smell it. So, here's my rendition of Caribbean coconut shrimp. My mother loves it. My father loves it. My family loves it. This tastes just like a wedding meal. Just like a wedding meal. So, I'm going to let it steep. Probably move it to another part of the stove that's not used, so it can cool down. And here it is. I have Caribbean coconut shrimp. There it is. Caribbean coconut shrimp. Ingredients: parsley, coconut oil, evaporated milk, cream of coconut oil, half a cup of water, and parsley. So peace out, guys. Peace. And there it is. Caribbean coconut shrimp.